Hey, scientist! We've almost finished learning about all the different classifications of animals. So far, we've learned about mammals, fish, birds, and reptiles, which just leaves us with our last category, amphibians. Let's take a look. Whoa! A toad? Wait! I thought a toad was a reptile. That makes me wonder. How are amphibians different from reptiles? Let's hop to it. Reptiles and amphibians have some of the same characteristics, so it makes sense that we might get them confused at first glance. Both reptiles and amphibians are cold-blooded creatures who usually lay eggs, but there are a lot of important differences that help us classify them differently. Let's take a closer look by comparing amphibians to reptiles using a T-chart, like this. A T-chart is a simple tool we can use to compare two things side by side. On one side, we'll list characteristics about reptiles, and on the other side, about amphibians. We already know many of the characteristics of reptiles. They lay hard, leathery eggs on land, they are born with lungs instead of gills, and they have dry scales covering their bodies. Let's compare these characteristics one at a time to the characteristics of an amphibian. As we go, we can fill in what we learn on our T-chart right here. Okay, reptiles lay hard, leathery eggs on land. Well, amphibians lay eggs too. Let's take a look. Whoa! These eggs look different from reptile eggs. What is something you observe, scientist? Yeah, these eggs don't look hard or leathery at all. In fact, they appear sort of squishy. Amphibians, like frogs, newts, and salamanders, lay soft, jelly-like eggs. And look, these eggs aren't on land. Amphibians lay their eggs in or near water. Let's add that to the chart. Pause here and write that down. There's a reason why amphibians lay soft eggs near the water. When amphibians are born, they have gills. Check out this tadpole here. A tadpole is a baby frog, but it looks sort of like a fish, right? Most baby amphibians live under the water, and as they grow, they go through a metamorphosis, where they grow legs and lungs. That's why you can see adult amphibians on land. The way they breathe typically changes over time. Most of them start their lives with gills, and by the time they are adults, they have lungs. That's something you don't see in any other class of animal. Pause the video here and add that to your T-chart. Great! Lastly, we know that reptiles have dry scales on their body. Let's take a look at an amphibian up close. Do you see any scales? No, me neither. In fact, this frog has skin that looks shiny and smooth. Amphibians don't have scales, fur, or feathers. They have moist skin that can be smooth like this frog's or bumpy like this toad's. Amphibian skin is special because amphibians are also able to breathe through their skin. The skin is very thin and can absorb oxygen from the water or the air. This gives them the ability to spend lots of time in the water, even after their gills have developed into lungs. Unlike reptiles who are very dry, amphibians are moist to the touch. The moistness of their skin is what helps them absorb oxygen, so it's very important that an amphibian doesn't get too dry. Amphibians are so unique. Even though they have some things in common with reptiles, like being cold-blooded and laying eggs, they have many characteristics that set them apart from every other class of animals, like their moist, breathable skin, how they undergo metamorphosis, and that they lay soft eggs in or near water. Now that we've learned about all five animal classifications, it's time to explore. Every time you see an animal, ask yourself, what classification does this belong to? Try to see how many different characteristics of that animal you can spot. And, as always, remember, science is all around you. Hey.